Hello, my name is Michael Stabin, and I will be your instructor in the RADAR Radiopharmaceutical Dosimetry course. This course has 10 modules or chapters. The first chapter just teaches basic techniques in internal dose calculations. Purpose of the course is to teach internal dose concepts, summarize the current best methods and models to use in internal dose assessment. There are many complicated systems out there. The RADAR system is a very simple one, and one of the goals is to show how all of these complicated systems are based down to a simple single system that can be used to describe all existing internal dose systems, both for radiopharmaceuticals, as in this course, and for radiation workers, which will be addressed at other times. Student will study various conceptual materials, receive explanations of the most useful existing documents and tools, and work through numerical examples. This, of course, is the most important part of the course. Looking at slides is interesting, but until you work out some real-life numerical examples, understanding is not complete. I started teaching this material many years ago, both occupational and pharmaceutical, and the systems look very different, very complicated, and I learned how to simplify them down to one simple equation that includes all of the complicated parts, but is much easier to use. In truth, internal dose calculations are not conceptually that difficult. We're just calculating energy per unit mass. But there are a lot of contributing terms, and this, we just have to add up all the parts of those terms. Computers are useful for that, and we're going to use computers whenever possible. As we'll show in this lecture, there is only one equation that you need to know. All of these other equations, MIRD, ICRP, etc., they're based on this one very simple equation. And so when you understand the simple one, we'll show you how that applies to all the more complicated ones with the myriad of different equations and terms. Just learn this one equation and you'll understand internal dosimetry. Its application, of course, depends on knowing where to find all of the input to the various terms. The principal quantity of interest we're going to use is, or work towards, is absorbed dose, energy per unit mass, and the equivalent dose, which is energy per unit mass modified by certain radiation weighting factors. Our ultimate goal in any internal dose assessment is the protection of people. These quantities, absorbed dose, equivalent dose, are well correlated with with radiation effects, and we'll have an entire lecture about radiation biology. But first we got to calculate a dose and then relate that to observed effects. Now, the absorbed dose, as defined by the ICRU, International Commission on Radiological Units, is DEDM, or D epsilon DM, if you wish, where DE is the mean energy imparted by ionizing radiation to matter of mass DM. The units are ergs per gram or joules per kilogram. The newer SI units are joules per kilogram. The older traditional units are ergs per gram. The special units of absorbed dose are rad, which is 100 erg per gram, or gray, which is 1 joule per kilogram. And if you work out the conversions, a gray is equivalent to 100 rad.